So we're going to go right straight to our co-main event. Roberto Ali Yong and Estevan Payan. Estevan Payan El Terrible, you'll see in a minute, fought in the UFC and Bellator. Roberto Ali Yong making his way to the cage. Took the fight today, Jamie. We talked about it in the intro earlier. He was taking a nap. The phone rang. His manager, Maurice Esposito, said, hey, Rage in the Cage has a fight for you tonight against Estevan Payan. Are you in? He said, I'm on my way. 6 feet, 172 pounds. He's a boxer, a very good one, who turned into an MMA fighter. He's 2-1. We've seen him a couple of times here at Rage in the Cage. Had a devastating knockout win over Philip Rowe, then lost in our last fight card to Joel Champion.
He's a tough guy. I'm a big fan of Roberto Yong. I like the way he throws down. I like his swagger in there. He doesn't talk crap. He lets his fighting do the talking for him, as opposed to his opponent. Payan is not a liked fighter amongst the MMA community here in Arizona, but he does do a good job. But Roberto Yong, this is a great step up in competition. And you know, I'm kind of excited to see how he does, because this will like cast some light on where he is in the whole scheme of things, professionally speaking. Is he ready for that next level show, or does he need more work here in Rage in the Cage?
Well, and you know that he's sparred with Estevan in the past, and you know that if they stay on the feet, that he could have some success in this fight, as any boxer can. He knows how to throw those hands. He trains at the MMA lab, and you know he can fight coming out of there. And look, there's Estevan Payan. I mean, Estevan's no slouch. He hasn't had a lot of luck on the higher levels. You look at his recent fights in the UFC, three of them in a row in the UFC were losses, two of them knockouts by punches. Came back to get a win here at Rage in the Cage last August against Eric Regan. Unanimous decision. Went right up to Bellator. Lost by first round knockout to Derek Campos. And then went to Titan FC in March and lost a unanimous decision to Brian Davidson. So he's lost five out of his last six fights. He got called up to the UFC not that long ago, just a couple of years ago. So we know he can fight. What people tell me about Payan, Jamie, is he's a beast in the gym. Trevor Lally told me this. He's a beast at Arizona Combat Sports, but has had a little bit of trouble carrying that over into his fights for some reason. Do you think that's fair?
Well, I mean, we're using bigger gloves, we're using headgear, and most guys don't go 100% in sparring. And Estevan is one of those guys that does go 100% in sparring. When you go to that next level and you're wearing those 4-ounce gloves, you got a tape job instead of just using regular hand wraps, there's more padding. Plus, he's wearing headgear. It's not the same blunt force trauma that you're getting in an MMA fight.
And of course, Estevan was scheduled to fight, as you know, Ray Robinson in a rematch. They fought a couple of years back on a Rage in the Cage card, and Estevan pulled out a submission win late, so now he's got to adjust his game plan. I was next to him in the lunchroom today when he got the call that he would be fighting Roberto Yong. He was game to do it. He's going to go try to play college football after this. He's a veteran. He fought his way into the world. He grew up in a tough spot, so you know he's been fighting for everything his whole life. And like him or not, and he's a polarizing guy, no question, but he's had to earn everything he's ever gotten in his life, and that deserves some respect.
I agree. I have gone multiple rounds with Estevan in the cage. I've actually trained with both these guys, but Estevan helped me maintain and win a world title, He was one of my sparring partners for a long time. He helped me get back into the UFC. Again, one of my sparring partners. Tough dude, just not a likable guy.
And a lot of people would agree with that, but he definitely has a lot of respect within the MMA community. This might be his last fight. We don't know. Former Rage in the Cage and Trilogy champ Estevan Payan and Roberto Ali Yong in our co-main event. Let's go to Rick.
Ladies and gentlemen, this bout is brought to you by Muscle Maker Grill. And it is your co-main event of the evening. These are the principals on my left. Fighting out of the blue corner, he's wearing red shorts with black trim. He is 5'11" tall, weighed in at 153 pounds, with a record of 2 wins, 1 loss. His hometown is Sacramento, California, and he fights out of the lab. Please welcome Ali Yong! His opponent on my right, wearing black trunks, red trim, fighting out of the red corner. is 5'9" tall, weighed in at 153 pounds. With a record of 15 wins, 8 losses, he hails from Glendale, Arizona, where he fights out of the Arizona Combat Sports. Please welcome Estevan El Toro Payan.
El Terrible, not Toro.
El Terrible. Sounds a little tart, sorry. All right, third man in the cage, Ryan Brueggemann.
Fighters, we went over your instructions in the dressing room. Protect self at all times. Obey my commands at all times. Touch gloves now if you wish. Come out swinging.
All right, Payan and Roberto Ali Yong. That should be 170 to 175 catchweight. 2-1 for Yong, 15-8-1 for Payan. Payan in his 30s, Yong at 29, 6 feet 5'9", and then 79 and 72 on the reach. The tail of the tape presented by the Muscle Maker Grill. Estevan Payan on your right in the dark trunks. Roberto Ali Yong wearing the red, fighting out of the blue corner. Jamie, and Payan knows to be very careful with those hands of Roberto Yong, but he's certainly not afraid to stand on his feet and scrap against anybody.
No, I mean, I don't think he's fighting the right game plan, though. He needs to just get this thing close and take him down. Estevan does not have a good chin. He knows that. His trainers know that. I talked to Jameson White earlier. The game plan is to get in close and take this fight to the ground. But El Terrible is very stubborn, and he hates not being better than the guys and what they're best at. He likes to beat the guy at what they're best at. But it's going to be hard to beat a seasoned professional boxer in the boxing aspect of things.
That's a very good point. I mean, you're a mixed martial artist for a reason. As Yong catches Payan, and Payan falls down. He got hit by a hard right hand, and he's in trouble now early on. Estevan Payan fighting off his back against an onslaught from Roberto Yong, but look at the body triangle now. He picks him up for the slam. Payan goes for the armbar. Looking for another slam.
The crowd loves that. The triangle is locked in. The triangle is locked in. This is where you don't want to be.
Payan trying to hold it through these series of slams from
Yong. Get up. Oh, yep.
And now he's able to escape his back, courtesy of the jiu-jitsu, which is what you were talking about.
Estevan has a superior jiu-jitsu here. I mean, Roberto is the more seasoned striker. Estevan is an MMA fighter. He has done everything. He has done kickboxing. He has done boxing. He has done wrestling. He has done grappling. He is a tough guy, and he's not to sleep on the ground. He does have good submissions, especially trained under Steve Rosenberg.
Payan back against the fence, now throwing more knees out of the clinch at Roberto Yong, who's coming in on him hard. Payan did get caught with a right in that exchange a few seconds ago, and now Payan with the leg kick. That's a big leg kick on Roberto Young's left leg there.
That was a huge leg kick, but
some big knees now from Payan up against the cage, and now Roberto Yong is in trouble. The Muay Thai coming in for Payan, and now he hits him with a hard right. Estevan Payan taking control of this fight. It's the knees in the clinch right now for Estevan Payan.
I don't think Roberto Yong was properly conditioned for the war and the battle that Estevan brings to every fight. Estevan is a tough, grinding fighter. He can just keep coming. The guy's got like a third lung. He never gets tired. That was one thing with Estevan. He would go out and party all night, and then he'd be able to do 15 rounds with 5 different guys in the gym. He is a tough gym opponent. But they are both just going to battle. This is the fight of the night right here. I love this fight. I love this round. Nice knees to the head there by Estevan.
Remember, these are 5-minute rounds, so the conditioning is a big factor.
Absolutely, but Roberto Yong, I mean, he was on his couch this morning. I mean, he woke up like, yeah, I'll fight. He wasn't training, he wasn't prepared. Estevan has been trained for this fight for months, probably his whole life. He's been trained for a fight like this.
Nice block on that kick by Payan. The crowd loving it here with all the action. Estevan Payan drops Roberto Yong and pounces on him. Roberto Yong better hang on and survive here. Estevan Payan all over him with the ground and pound. Now in the full mount of Roberto Yong. Now he has his back. Yong can't see those punches coming now.
This is a tough position to be in. I can't believe Estevan just let him up. Oh man, now he's got a second to catch his breath. That's ultimately what Roberto Yong needed right there. He needed a second to catch his breath. Payan is taking it to him. This is what Payan does, though. He takes guys into deep water, he out-conditions them, and then he beats them up. It's what he does. I have been sparred this guy many of rounds, and he just gets you tired, then he comes back like an animal.
So we continue with Payan and Roberto Yong here. What a round this has been, Jamie. Estevan continuing to slug away in tight, knees and hooks. Uppercut there, and a big right hand with the hook from Payan. Continuing to throw those knees at Yong, whose face is cut now.
I mean, we gotta remember, Roberto Yong woke up this morning like, oh shoot, I'm gonna get in a fight tonight. Like, he had no idea. He had no train, no preparation. The fact that he even took the fight and is putting on this kind of fight of the night performance is huge.
Big right from Payan stuns Roberto Yong, who's now covering up for dear life. That was a huge right hand from Estevan.
And big knees. Look at the clinch game. And this is what Trevor Lally and Jameson White wanted this fight to be. They wanted it to be a nice, tight fight, putting pressure on him, getting him tired, clinch him. Do not give him space to throw punches.
Oh, big knee to the head now from Payan. 10 seconds remaining in the round. Looks like Roberto Yong will survive. An absolute offensive onslaught by Estevan Payan El Terrible with a huge performance after a slow start in round number one.
What a tough, tough round. What a back and forth round. This was probably my favorite round in Rage in the Cage history. I mean, Estevan was hurt getting dropped. Then you see Roberto Yong getting hurt and getting wobbled on his legs and knees and oh my God, getting his leg kicked out. What a great round. Clearly that round goes to Estevan Payan, but the heart and the grit that Roberto Yong brings into this fight is unbelievable.
As you take a look at Rage Babe Deidre, the crowd loving it, all the action in this fight. Jamie, let's take a look at the replay. Estevan Payan dropping Roberto Yong and then right on top of him with the ground and pound.
Yeah, I'm surprised he couldn't finish him here, but those leg kicks, if you want to chop down a tree, you want to keep a puncher from being able to punch you hard, take his legs out from underneath him. Power comes from the ground up. A boxer needs his legs underneath him to generate power to those punches. Now, this is where Estevan is going to flourish. Conditioning is what Estevan does best.
Estevan Payan
a warrior.
Is 7-0 on the crimson canvas, Jamie. Has never lost here in Rage in the Cage, former welterweight champion years ago, and then, of course, went on to the UFC and Bellator. He did get hit a couple of times, did get rocked a couple of times by Roberto Yong. As we begin round number two, I think Estevan will be looking a little bit more toward that MMA style with the Muay Thai and the Jiu-Jitsu that helped him so much in that first round.
Oh, man, look at Roberto Yong throwing his kicks now. Didn't see that one coming. Throwing his knees. He took a page out of Estevan's book going into the second round.
Well, you know he fights at the lab, so you know he's good at jiu-jitsu and Muay Thai. They're a very well-rounded gym. They have great instructors in every discipline. So, you know, sometimes when things get a little rough on you, you fall back to what you're best at, and the other guy's waiting for it. So Young's got to be careful of that as well. Everybody knows he's going to go back to boxing when he's in trouble. And there's a big right to the chin of Estevan Payan. Estevan cut and bleeding from his right eye profusely.
Estevan has been known to get cut in a lot of his fights. He's got really high eyebrow bones, and those are just not good. If you remember Nick Diaz, he had to get his shaved down so he wouldn't keep cutting in his fights.
Oh, nice combination from Payan coming back. The counterpunch off the cage, and he gets drilled a couple of times. Another left from Roberto Yong, and now a big left from Payan. Look at this exchange from these two fighters. It's a war in there.
This is probably one of my favorite fights I've ever seen in Rage in the Cage. What a back and forth battle.
What a back and forth came out again.
One thing we didn't touch on is Roberto Yong hit him with a right hand and a left hook combination that hurt and stunned Estevan. But you're noticing the power in his punches has dropped significantly in the second round. I think it's one due to conditioning, and also those leg kicks are starting to add up.
Great point, Jamie. Obviously, those knees and those kicks taking their toll on the punching power of Roberto Yong. But what a fight for Yong to wake up this morning and take this fight, drive up here, get here at about 5:30, and fight a couple hours
nice
later.
Nice right hand for Yong.
And Payan to have to adapt to a new opponent after Ray Robinson could not go after weigh-ins last night. And these two guys both landing solid shot. Another right from Roberto Yong. Solid shot after solid shot being landed by both fighters. Yong with his hands down. Interesting style there from the boxer, but both guys super tough. absorbing a lot of punishment in this fight, Jamie.
You know, Estevan's chin was in question going into this fight, but he's eaten some pretty hard shots from Roberto Yong and hasn't gone down yet. Has not gone down at all.
Trying to sink in a choke now is Estevan Payan. He had it locked in for a second. Now a big knee to the head, followed by a right. And he backs away from that uppercut thrown by Yong. Payan really bleeding, as you can see, from that right eye. But Young's face is all cut up as well.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure a doctor's going to need to step in and look at that fight, because now that blood's starting to trickle into Estevan's eye. I do not want this fight to get stopped, but it wouldn't surprise me at this point.
I wouldn't want to be the guy who stops this fight if you're telling Estevan Payan he can't continue.
You imagine
this, happy camper.
You imagine this fight with Roberto Yong having a full training camp and 100% conditioning? I mean, this is already a war, but can you imagine five rounds of this toe-to-toe battling action between these two guys? Unreal.
Yeah, and Roberto Yong, the boxer, of course, has landed some significant shots to the face of Estevan Payan. Payan has thrown a lot himself, hit him with knees, kicks, punches in tight, and now he backs away from that big left uppercut from Roberto Yong, and that leg kick snapped right to that hamstring in the back of the knee of Roberto Yong. And there's another one leading into the fence now with a knee to the gut and now the right hand. So Payan, some nice combinations on his way in.
I don't understand what Roberto Yong is doing, but I need to see Estevan start throwing high kicks. When a guy's put his hands down by his knees or on his legs, throw a high kick. At least throw it out there. Get him to think about something else. You know, you're letting him be in the driver's seat doing that stuff and not acting or reacting to that. That's terrible posture. Should not be doing that in a fight. And so I'm surprised Estevan hasn't gone upstairs with a kick yet.
Another right hand from Roberto Yong, and there's a nice left from Payan, who now pushes Yong into the fence one more time. A big knee to the forehead from Estevan Payan.
That knee
left
landed
from Roberto Yong.
On the forearm of Roberto Yong. Oh,
another
man.
Right from Yong. Payan's in trouble against the fence now. Look at him saying, come on, hit me again. Oh, and the big right once again from Yong. Under a minute left in the round. And Ryan Brueggemann.
Oh, he's hurt.
Estevan picking up his mouthpiece. Estevan Payan, a very tough guy.
Both these guys are exhausted. Both these guys are exhausted. There is a big, big cut over the left, over the right eye of Estevan. I am surprised that the ref has not stepped in to have a doctor look at this shit yet.
The blood just flew almost right near us, Jamie, off of Payan's face. And now he comes right at Yong. He's fine in there fighting. It's just the blood can be dangerous. But Estevan staying in tight, now trying to continue with the Muay Thai with the knees to the midsection. Has to really watch that right eye. One more shot or two, and he could be in really big trouble if he's not already.
Roberto Yong needs to stop trying to kickbox and just box Estevan. He's not winning this. He's not winning the kickboxing match.
Those punches missing from Yong. Estevan walking away. Maybe feeling like he won that round. What a battle.
Wow.
Estevan Payan and Roberto Yong. Two rounds of absolute MMA at its best, Jamie Varner. Roberto Yong exhausted, hands on the knees. He's thrown everything he can at Estevan Payan, has not been able to finish him, and he's feeling it right now. Meanwhile, Payan in his corner, he's got that big cut over his right eye, and he is fighting like the warrior that he is. Both of these guys, I'm so impressed, Jamie, with this fight so far.
This is awesome. You see Doc Graham. What a professional Doc Graham is. He is not going to stop this fight. He saw the cut, where the position of the cut was, let the corner man do his job, put some Vaseline in there. Great. Great fight, doctor, but this is one of the most amazing fights I've ever seen. And I've been fortunate enough to be in battles like this with guys like Donald Cerrone, Abel Trujillo. This is probably one of my favorite fights in Rage in the Cage history. And the fact that Roberto Yong just took this fight this morning, unbelievable heart and grit coming into this. What a great fight. I love this fight. I may have different opinions about Estevan, but these guys are awesome.
The third and final round, there's Estevan Payan egging the crowd on. And Roberto Yong, nice show of respect there from Estevan. And they will, look at that, hugging it up and ready for more battle. Round number three, and here they come. Estevan Payan coming right at you. Now on your left with the black trunks outlined in red. The red trunks with the black waistband for Roberto Yong. Muscle Maker Grill brings you round number three between these two great fighters.
Oh, man. Estevan doing what Estevan does. Put pressure, go forward, try and clinch, close that distance. I do not, Roberto needs to stop throwing kicks. He needs to just focus on his punches, maybe make a miss, go into some counter punching. You can tell he's obviously exhausted.
Exhausted,
but honestly, this fight is up for grabs right now. I gave the second round to Roberto. I gave the first round clearly to Estevan. This round could determine what happens in this fight.
Yeah, there it is right there from Payan. Drops him with the kick and then the knee. Roberto Young's in big trouble up against that fence. Payan all over him, hitting him with shot after shot. And Roberto Young in serious jeopardy here with Estevan Payan, who's been in this position before, continuing to wail away on him.
No, Roberto Young is doing a good job of keeping himself covered up, not taking too much damage, but he's exhausted. He is tired. And now, unlike earlier when we saw Clayton Carpenter, some of the other earlier fights, these guys are allowed to throw elbows on top, on the ground. It doesn't matter. They can throw elbows now. That's where things get dangerous. Estevan letting him up.
I wonder why. Why would you let him up?
Because he sees that he's exhausted. He's not worried about his power anymore, which could be a big mistake. But Estevan, he's a true professional. Got a lot of fights underneath his belt.
Oh, big leg kick, and now Young goes down again. Yeah, he is exhausted. That leg kick buckled him in a huge right knee to the back from Payan.
This is a true testament to how tough Roberto Young is. He has every reason to give up, every reason to quit, but yet he keeps fighting. This is a fighter's fighter. I love this guy. I love what he's about, and I love what he's doing for Rage in the Cage right now. This is one of the best fights I've ever seen.
Absolutely phenomenal, and it came together last minute. Nolan Hyland, our matchmaker, refusing to give up on this co-main event, finds Roberto Young, the great boxer, to come up here today and fight Estevan Payan after Ray Robinson couldn't do it following the weigh-in. Young barely able to defend himself. He's got nothing on those punches. He's close to out, Jamie, on his feet. He's completely exhausted.
He's just exhausted.
Not defending himself at all, and he is fair game right now for Payan. This thing should be stopped, and there it is. Estevan Payan with a huge win over Roberto Young. Oh, and he has some choice words for you when he comes by, Jamie, but you're retired now.
Yep. Yep. I am retired. It's funny. A guy that's been knocked out more times than I've lost fights.
I think maybe I'll take this interview.
Oh, yeah, go ahead.
All right, we'll do this. I don't know if we want to see a fight after the fight between Jamie Varner and Estevan Payan, so I will leave you with Jamie, and I'll go take this interview right after the official decision. Of course, the medic's still in there with Roberto Young.
Roberto Young is just exhausted. I mean, unbelievable fight. Took this fight short notice. What a tough guy. What a great fight. Estevan, he does what Estevan does. I mean, he goes out to every fight. He puts pressure on guys. He throws down. He wins. He wins based on conditioning and heart. Never can question Estevan's heart, but this is one of the best fights in the history of Rage in the Cage, and I'm so glad to be here calling this fight. No matter what my thoughts are of Estevan, this was a great fight to call. So excited to be here. But just look at those hammer fists at the end. Just took the legs out from underneath Roberto. What a great fight. Unreal. I can't say enough about this fight. What a great fight. I thoroughly enjoyed watching it as a fan. I love it. As a member and a part of the team here at Rage in the Cage, great job for putting this fight together. I would love to see a rematch when Roberto Young has a full training camp underneath his belt. Now we're going to take it up to the cage with Rockin' Rick Reyes.
All right, hey, ladies and gentlemen, before we get to this, okay, listen up. Ali Young, Roberto Young in the red, took this fight 6 hours ago. Give him some mad fucking mad respect. 6 hours ago, Estevan did not have a fight. Estevan's guy backed out of it last minute. Ali stepped up, man. Thank you so much. Let me give you the final word right now. Ladies and gentlemen, the official time, 2 minutes, 45 seconds of the third and final round. Your referee stopped contest. Your winner fighting out of the red corner, Estevan El Terrible Payan.
Wow. Hey, make some more noise for these guys. This is one of the best fights you'll ever see right here. Let them hear you, these two guys. Wow. Wait, hold on. We're going to talk to your winner, Estevan Payan, in a minute. But first, I want to talk to Roberto. Man, oh man, you are barely standing up right now. How about Roberto Yong, ladies and gentlemen? How about this warrior you see right in front of you? You took this fight this morning. You drove up here to fight a guy who's been in the UFC and Bellator, and you put on that kind of performance. I know it didn't end the way you wanted it to, man, but tell us how you feel. What a fight.
I feel great. Just, I shouldn't have got tired, but, you know, I was still rehabbing from the last fight. No training, no running, no nothing. Called this afternoon, and I never say no.
Never say no to that fight, and that's what we say is a true fighter, Roberto. Let's talk about those shots you were hitting him with early on, because you're a boxer, and you hit him with a lot of big shots, opened up that big cut over his eye. How surprised were you that you were not able to get that finish against Estevan here tonight?
I was a little surprised, but like I said, I knew what I was facing when I said, yeah, no training. It'll be another time, and I will be able to do what I want to do.
Well, these are the kind of fights that'll get you a lot of attention. I know how tired you are. We'll let you go, but what a performance. Roberto Yong, it was an honor to call that fight. Let him hear you one more time. Roberto Yong. Wow. Where's Estevan? Nice sportsmanship right there. Estevan, come on in here real quick. Let me ask you. I'll give it to you in a minute, but let me ask you a couple questions first, all right? Right that way. He hurt you pretty good early on. You fought through the cut and the blood. We know about your heart. You've been a fighter your whole life. Just take us through what happened in this fight early on when he caught you those few times and how you were able to come back.
First off, the cut I got on Wednesday. I just been covering it up, gluing it, hiding it so no one would see it. He hit me with it. He hit me, but he like just reopened it. It's an old cut. But like I said, I took bigger shots this time because I stopped being an idiot. I got to the UFC. I was so worried about everybody being in the UFC, like, why am I in the UFC? But I forgot how hard I worked to get there. And as soon as I got there, I was an idiot. I was partying, I was drinking. A week before my UFC fights, I was out getting fucked up. Sorry about the F word, but like I said, I messed up. I'm not saying I'm going to go back there. But like I said, just don't be like me. Don't. All you fighters that are here trying to make your way there, as soon as you get there, don't forget how hard you had to work, all the sacrifices you had to do to get there. I made it there, and I screwed up. I screwed myself. But like I said, no one believed I could ever get there. We had Varners, we had Baders. They used to tell Trevor, he'd never make it. He'll never get there. And like I said, I made it, and I was an idiot. Now I'm just going to school, and next month I'm going to try out for the football team. I'm going to be a 33-year-old freshman trying to play football.
Estevan Payan, ladies and gentlemen, let me ask you how you were able to get the finish in that fight. Jamie was saying it while you were fighting with him early on, standing up. Estevan's got to use his Muay Thai. It looked like those knees really got it going for you, and then the leg kicks.
Me and Ali have worked together. Like I said, me and Ali have boxed. I knew you guys were going to get fireworks. I knew that you were going to get it. I called. I told Nolan. I told Nathan, call Roberto Yong. We will give them a fight. Ray Robinson, he didn't get injured. He knew he was going to get hurt. He knew what was going to happen. A focused El Terrible is a real El Terrible. I ain't El Toro. All you guys can call me El Toro. It's El Terrible. You guys remember that.
Estevan, one more, real quick. Does this mean you're done? Are you done fighting? Is this it for you?
Like I said, I'm going to try out for the football team. If I don't make it, I'll still come here and I'll put shows on for you guys. You can always count on having a fight when I'm here. Like I said, I want to thank Ali. Brother, I love you, Ali. We don't even make that much money. They didn't even offer me any extra money to take a fight with someone of this caliber. They didn't find out. Ollie, you better not have made more than me. I'm gonna be pissed. But yeah, we don't make nothing. I made $1,000 to come fight. Did you guys get your money's worth? Did you get your money's worth? Make sure to buy Ollie a drink.
I'll take a couple myself.